here we are with another movie review, same as before. I think this time I'll talk about a movie known, well, it's more of a original versus ripoff, I should say. Technically now the company that made the original is now owned by the ripoff company. But I digress, it was still a ripoff at the time. See if you can figure out the movie, the original or the remake that I'm talking about. It's basically, you know, opens up in a room where it's full of toys, and then as soon as there are no humans around, or animals in one of the cases, the toys start coming alive. Sound familiar to anybody? Alright, you ready for the answer? The original is, well, is known as A Christmas Toy, which was originally made by Jim Henson, creator of the Muppets, which now it is owned by the company who ripped off A Christmas Toy, which you could probably figure out is Disney. Also, then the movie they used to rip it off was Toy Story. Basic same concept in the first movie as in the original. You have a toy that it's, well, in Toy Story it's birthday, but this time it's Christmas. Because, you know, it's a Christmas movie. And, oh, let's see, you have a toy that's wanting to be the center of attention. Who's the current favorite toy? I'm going to die here. Oh, well. Oh, crap, not oh, well. I don't have... keep inventory on, which I normally do, but you know. But anyways, the toy in question is actually a stuffed tiger, but you know, in Toy Story it's obviously Woody. Now, there are some differences, but we'll get to that eventually. But in Christmas Toy, he still wants to be the center of attention, which obviously so does Woody. But he's wanting to try to take over the new Christmas toy so he can be the new Christmas, you know, toy, because he was given the year before. Which, to a little girl by the name of Jamie, and the irony is her brother is named Jesse. Yeah. Wonder if there was any more ripoffs there. But anyways. The year before he was given, actually another... toy was actually given as a Christmas present. Her name was Apple. She looks like the female version of Chucky. There's no way around that. She's just the female version of Chucky. I mean, she doesn't act like it, but... I gotta get away from here. I have no food. I have no bed. But... she really doesn't like rugby. I think she's still kind of jealous on, you know, but she handled it way better than he did. But she, let go of the mouse there for a second. She's the voice of reason, and you know, even though she was the favorite toy, she's not anymore. Well, sort of not. if you were a kid growing up, you know, you had your favorites, and then you had some, but you loved all your toys. I know I did. But anyways, he goes out and tries to, again, take over being the Christmas toy, which is a really stupid thing, because unlike in Toy Story, there's actually a reason why they're supposed to stay where they're, you know, they're not supposed to be found out of place. Even the cat toy, which I'll get to the cat toy in a moment. Because if you don't, then, well, if you get caught out of place, you're supposed to be frozen forever. Which, yeah. It's obvious at the end of the movie, all the toys that were frozen become unfrozen. Without much of an explanation why. Possible Christmas miracle, possible power of love kind of thing. But I'm going to die, so I'm going to unload my stuff here, actually. But they, like I said, they... So, but, yeah, it's... And, you know, they give a great explanation of why they shouldn't do it. And, you know, says, hey, there are repercussions if you don't listen to the rules. The rules are there for a reason, and, you know, unlike in Toy Story, which they really leave it open on why. They don't really explain. I'm going to let myself get killed. But, so, you know. Yeah, and Toy Story is just the way the rules are. Don't know why, but, you know. Tis what it is. Boom. Hi, Bob. Thank you, Bob. So, anyways, I digress. However, in Christmas Toy, they, like I said, they have the reason. Alright, so we got the toy that's jealous, that wants to stay the popular toy. We also get a new toy that's in the Christmas present, the Christmas toy, which Rugby does end up activating its consciousness. And let's see if it reminds you of anything. It's a space-themed toy who doesn't realize it's a toy. Sound familiar? Yeah, Buzz Lightyear was heavily inspired, ripped off by Meteora. Meteora is the name of the new toy. And oh, the cat toy, by the way, its name is Mew. And he is the one that, and he actually is hated by all the other toys. But eventually he becomes best friends with Rugby, the lion toy. And, yeah, he's actually one of my favorite characters in the movie. I could relate. I was that kid growing up that nobody really liked for one reason or another. But, anyways. Yeah, he gives a big speech, and at first, you know, Rugby didn't want to listen until he pointed out, yeah, if you don't, you know, get yourself back upstairs where you belong, you're going to be frozen forever. And he's like, oh, crap, I didn't think about that. But, of course, they got to get the new toy to realize it's a toy and put back in its box, you know, because, well, it's supposed to be in the box until Christmas morning. And, yeah, they eventually do get her back in there. The motivated tree disintegration. Anyways, very heavily inspired by Buzz is inspired by her. The irony, though, is seems more like she's a villain, but you know. Need to start looking for food. Yeah, so as you can tell, very heavily ripped off. And you know, of course, now Disney owns Muppets, which means they own the Christmas toys, so I don't know if it's considered a ripoff anymore, even though originally it was. But it's blatantly obvious what they did, if you ever seen the movie Christmas Toy, which, by the way, for those of you interested in wanting to check it out, it is free on YouTube, at least right now, as of recording this video. Get back to the musing, I almost forgot. The cat gets a new toy. And, okay, the cat toy is introducing itself to the new toy, and it's like, "Hi, I'm Mew." And the other one's like, "I'm Mew too." Yeah, you know where this is going. Well, this one might have been just a coincidence, but yeah, if you didn't know, there's two Pokemon by the names of Mew and Mewtwo. Now, the difference is, in this case, the cat toy is a mouse. Well, it looks like a mouse. Both of them are. And in Pokemon, they're actually, if you didn't realize it, they're cats. Which, you know, hence why they were called, named Mew and Mewtwo, I think is really what it boils down to on them. But it does make you wonder if it was inspired. But, because, yeah, obvious that, you know, Disney ripped it off. Now, I don't know which came first, Child's Play or Christmas Toy, so I don't know. who's playing off who on this one? Though, well, we all know that Buddy Dolls were the real inspiration for Chucky, which sucked. I had a Buddy Doll, I loved it, even after I watched the Child's Play movie. Where's my base? I need to cook my food. There it is. There we are. So, yeah. Christmas Toy, very great movie. I do highly recommend, and at least as of right now, it's free on YouTube. There actually are a lot of other good Christmas movies that are free on YouTube. Since this has been pretty short, I'll go ahead and mention a few of them. One of my favorites is The Homecoming. Which, if you don't know what that is, it's actually basically the pilot to the TV show The Waltons. If you've never seen The Waltons, well, you're either really young or where the hell have you been? The Waltons was an amazing show. I grew up watching it with my mother. And it was one of the things we loved to do together. And, well, so, you know, it's got a lot of sentimental value to me, that show. And obviously the Christmas show. I do, like I said, you should go watch it to get a really good idea of it's a different time period kind of thing. You know, not quite Pioneer, because they're pretty, it's pretty much settled. Their cars are around. It's based off a true story written by Earl Hamner Jr., which I believe there is a book series, which if there is, I definitely want to read. The father in the story is, at least for the movie, the homecoming movie, Christmas movie, he's off doing some work and is expected home earlier in the day, and there was a snowstorm, and his bus actually got into an accident, which, spoilers, he was not on it. He decided to walk home, which is why he was so late. Otherwise, he might have actually been in a hospital. So, you know, he got lucky on that. Mother sent John Boy, which is Earl Hamner Jr.'s character. Well, he's not played by Earl Hamner Jr. It's just, that's, you know, well, it's based off a true story. That was about Earl Hamner Jr.'s life. Which, if by some miracle one of his family members happens to listen to this, Earl Hamner is a great, Earl Hamner Jr. was a great author. But yeah. It's a good testament of the times that they were in. They were not a rich family, even though the mountain was theirs. I mean, I don't know how much how it legally worked back then, because, you know, basically their family was the first ones on the mountain. But yeah, got the Baldwin ladies who sold Papa's recipe, which I don't know if they, in real life, they realized what the recipe was or not. But see, this was back in the days of Prohibition. And so, yeah, selling alcohol was kind of illegal. And it was their papa's recipe, who happened to be a judge. But they're in the movie, and they're decorating the tree. And they're actually really good people, at least in the movie and TV show. Should start clearing an area to make a base. But yeah, there's not really much more to say about it. It's a good movie. You really should go watch it. Again, it's free on YouTube, at least as of the posting of this video. Another free movie that's on YouTube, again, at least as of right now when I'm posting this, they may not be, you know, years down the road or a few months or whatever, but another good movie that I recommend watching that's free on YouTube is called Mrs. Santa Claus. It stars Angela Lansbury, which we all know is a great actress, and if you don't know, if you've seen the original Beauty and the Beast, she's Mrs. Potts. And, you know, if you haven't seen the original Beauty and the Beast, you should go watch it. The remake is great. I actually, in some ways, think it's better than the original, but we'll get to that in a different review if I haven't already done it. I can't seem to keep track of which movies I've reviewed already and which ones I haven't. But it's just a kind of a story about Mrs. Santa Claus during, I don't even think there was cars back then, so it's still horse and buggy times there. But, you know, back in a time when women were trying to fight for the right to vote, because one of the women in the show, the movie, is actually, you know, is actually protesting for women's rights to vote. Which, she is not getting much sympathy by the other women until Mrs. Santa Claus gives them the hand. What happened in the movie is it starts out with her wanting to help Santa Claus, making his new job easier, and she made a new route, and he's not bad. It's Santa. He's not bad, but he's very busy, and he wasn't really listening to her, so she decides to go test out her route herself. And there ended up being a storm, and one of the reindeer get hurt. I think it was Comet. And she's gets stuck for about a week in New York. She makes a whole bunch of friends, and she does a lot of help for them in the community while she's there. I mean, it's Mrs. Santa Claus. Of course she's going to be doing community work. But, let's see, what was the toy company's name? I forget. Well, she works for a toy company while she's there, and it doesn't go over well because the guy in charge is a jerk. And they try to give you a sympathetic backstory for him, but, you can't sympathize with him. I had an older brother that was a bully, too, and I turned out fine. I love Christmas, I love kids, I love toys to this day. I don't play with toys, but I like collecting them. Though, I'll usually give my kids the toys first, and then once they get old enough where they're not going to be enjoying the toys, then I'm going to take the ones that can be used as a collection and display them. Crap, I'm lost again. Huh. Which is the only reason why it's bad is because if I die, I don't know if I'd be able to find my stuff. Wait, is this it? Whoa. But Parish Toys, I think, might have been what it was called. The toy company, I'm not sure. It's a really good movie. It's an older movie, but, and that's the thing, with a lot of younger kids today, some of the older movies, they just don't even want to think about watching, even though they're good movies. I'm in trouble. Oh, sweet. You see that over there, people? That is a underwater temple. We will be going there at some point. Now, I'm trying to think of some other things to say about it, but dang spider. Sorry, just kind of get away. Me. Now, let's see. I'm trying to think if there was any other free movies on YouTube. I'll have to look to see if there's any good free Christmas movies on YouTube so I can recommend more. But those three are really good Christmas movies. Yeah, a little old, but they're great. And, again, the one, Toy Story ripped off the one, so it's basically the same freaking plot with Toy Story in this movie. Ah, stupid little kid. Stupid little kid. Run. But, anyways, Oh, hey, cows. You're not what I need. Distraction. Stupid little kids. And in case you're wondering, I get that from Impulse and Skizzleman. And that's how what they refer to the baby zombies as. Where is my safety area? Said no, but I think I might be close. But yeah, I'm not sure. Distracted. Ooh, actually, I don't have to clear this area out. If I can, this actually would be. I like this area. I am going to have to stop here for now, because I can't think of anything else to say about the movies I just talked about. Like I said, at least as of right now, they are free on YouTube. I recommend you watch them while you got a chance to see them for free. Well, have fun.